They were doing work on I-40 to make the interstate safer when they were wiped out by an out-of-control RV.
News 13's Nancy Laughlin just returned from Gallup. She's in the Newsplex with the latest.
Well, Jess, state police tell us so far the 67-year-old driver in that RV that plowed into those workers has not been charged with any crimes.
It's hard because we're family here in Valley Fans.
A family of employees who have been through a lot. 9:30 this morning, surrounded by orange barrels and busy traffic, workers from Valley Fence Company out of Albuquerque were doing work on the median on I-40 in Gallup. They were about to install safety cables so drivers wouldn't cross the median when one of them did.
We understand is an RV went through the barricades and struck one of our trucks, which our men were standing around the truck.
It happened in front of traffic, in front of restaurants and hotels along the busy interstate. Keisha Dudley, who works at one of those restaurants, says she saw the small white RV, police cars, then.
I saw the ambulance come, the fire truck, and then when they pulled out the white sheets, you know, I was kind of sad then.
Because she knew the crash was fatal. Police tell us 20-year-old Johan Maroni Torres died at the scene. His dad has been with the fence company for years. They say two other workers were taken to a Gallup hospital, one with broken ribs. The other, 56-year-old Telemundo Antunez, who had been with the Valley Fence Company for 15 years, passed away too.
The company is just stunned. Valley Fence has been in business for 50 years, and we've never had a fatality in our jobs, and it's pretty rough.
State police tell us the driver of that RV, 67-year-old Lee McCray of Owensville, Indiana, was also taken to the hospital. They say he had some sort of medical episode when he went off the road and into the median, killing two men who were trying to make it safer.
Okay, as far as McCray, state police say his family was allowed to drive off in that RV. Whether he will face any charges, that's up to the district attorney. Back to you all.
Okay, Nancy, OSHA is also investigating this case to make sure the work zone was as safe as possible.
Police are investigating a burglary at